So about the apoptosis, as I said, that it is affecting a small group of cells. Necrosis was affecting the large group of cells. Apoptosis is kind of a suicide of the cell. Necrosis is kind of murder of the cell. So now we are going to talk about the apoptosis. Okay, apoptosis. Small group of cells are involving in this case. Now, apoptosis can be physiological and pathological, whereas necrosis is always and always pathological. Necrosis is always pathological. Apoptosis can be physiological as well as pathological. So, every time apoptosis is not bad. Okay, so apoptosis can be physiological as well as it can be pathological. Okay, in what cases it can be physiological, in what cases it can be pathological. Let's talk about some of the examples. For example, first example is the embryogenesis. We all are reading the textbooks from our childhood only, that we are having the evolution. Okay, how we appear in this world over here. So first of all, we were the chimpanzee and all, right? And all those things. So how the evolution happened. So if you talk about the evolution, first of all, let's say if the hand is appearing, okay, first of all, the fingers will not be appearing. It will be something like this. So this was you. Okay, what happened now? Look at the hand. This was your hand. First of all, your hand was like this. Okay, after that, after some weeks, what happened? Okay, after some more weeks, what happened? Okay. Okay, one more, some two more weeks. Yeah, now it's something like hand, right? Something like hand. So yeah, so what is happening? Look at this portion over here. And now look at this portion. Now look at this and now this one. What is happening? Evolution. Apoptosis is happening in between your fingers. Physiological or pathological? Physiological. If you will be appearing with this situation, what will be happening? This apoptosis is good for you. That's why it is considering under the physiological apoptosis. Okay, one more example, let's say. Embryogenesis we talked about. Let's talk about the leukocyte count. First of all, I'm telling you from the previous classes that if somebody is having the infection inside your body, somebody is having infection, leukocyte count will be elevated or decreased?
Elevated.
After you will be removing, you will be giving the antibiotics. So if you are giving the antibiotics, bacteria will be suppressed. Okay, you will be overcoming that situation. Now what will happen to the leukocyte count? Decreased. How it is decreasing? Apoptosis of those leukocytes. How it is decreasing? Apoptosis of those elevated leukocytes. It is physiological or pathological? Physiological only. So this can also be the example for the, so total leukocyte count can also be the example for physiological apoptosis. Physiological apoptosis. One more example. In cases of females, they're having the menstrual periods. What is happening in the menstrual periods? Due to the lack of progesterone and estrogen, endometrial lining is shedding off. Endometrial lining is shedding off. So what is happening? How the endometrial lining is shedding off? By the help of apoptosis. By the help of apoptosis. Okay. So in every month, endometrial lining is getting proliferation, and every month it is getting shedding off until and unless there is no pregnancy. Okay. Because in the pregnancy, progesterone levels will be high, and during the 9 months of the pregnancy, progesterone level will always remain high, because if the progesterone levels will be decreased, there will be the chances of Yeah, losing of the pregnancy. There are the chances of abortions, okay, or miscarriages. So this is also the example of which kind of apoptosis? Physiological apoptosis. Understood about the examples? Okay, now let's move on to the pathological apoptosis. Okay, pathological apoptosis, one of the example is the retinitis pigmentosa. Retinitis pigmentosa, in which pathologically you're having the damage of the retina. Pathologically you are having damage of the retina. Okay, next example, you know, viral hepatitis. In the viral hepatitis, you can see, you know, the marker of the viral hepatitis, you can see the councilman bodies. You can see what? Councilman bodies. This is very important for the exam's point of view. So councilman bodies, you can see in the viral hepatitis. What is happening? Hepatocytes are getting destruction. Physiological or pathological? Pathological, because it is happening due to virus. Okay, which kind of hepatitis is more dangerous? First of all, how many kinds of viral hepatitis do we know? E. E means like A, B, C, D, E, right? Viral hepatitis B is the most dangerous one. Okay, so viral hepatitis is also having the councilman bodies appearance. Okay, this is the examples for the pathological apoptosis. Okay, now before discussing about the steps inside the apoptosis, you know, we are having the intrinsic pathway. As we talk about coagulation cascade, we are having the intrinsic and the extrinsic pathway. Likewise, in the apoptosis also, we are having the intrinsic and extrinsic pathway. But before that, I want to talk about some genes, which are the pro-apoptotic genes and the anti-apoptotic genes. Okay, just remember the names, few of them, pro-apoptotic and anti-apoptotic. So shall we rub this portion now? Shall we rub? So about the genes, pro-apoptotic and okay, listen, what happened suddenly? Overexcited. Everybody wants stabilization, everybody wants the valency, you get super excited. Anyways, pro-apoptotic and anti-apoptotic genes. The example of the pro-apoptotic are BAK, BACs, and P53. These genes are the pro-apoptotic genes, which means they will be stimulating the cell to go for apoptosis. Okay? On the other side, we are having anti-apoptotic, which means they will be resisting the apoptosis. They will be resisting the apoptosis. So these kind of genes can lead to cancer. These kind of genes can lead to cancer because apoptosis is very, very important. I told you physiological and pathological. So physiological apoptosis is important or not for your body? Yes, it is important, because if the apoptosis will not be able to happen, cells will start increasing inside your body. If the cells will start increasing in your body, it might lead to what? Cancer. Malignant cancer, for example, it might lead to the tumor formation also. So anti-apoptotic genes, which are the examples? BCL-XL or BCL2. BCL-XL or BCL2, these are the two examples for the anti-apoptotic genes. So remember about these examples we are going to use in the intrinsic pathway. Okay, in the intrinsic pathway. So BACs and P53, BCL-XL and BCL2. Okay. Fine. Shall we talk about now intrinsic and extrinsic pathways? Okay. So let's talk about the intrinsic and extrinsic pathways now for the apoptosis. So intrinsic pathway for the apoptosis. Nice. Intrinsic pathway of the apoptosis. So look what is happening over here. Let's say this is what? Inside the cell, this is what? Mitochondria. Of course, we are talking about cell injury. We'll be talking about the cells again and again, right? So this mitochondria is present in this cell, let's say. Okay, and this cell has to undergo apoptosis. This cell has to undergo apoptosis. What will be happening? Look, inside the mitochondria, we are having the pro-apoptotic gene. This is the pro-apoptotic gene. The name of this gene is P53. The name of this gene is P53. Now, what will be happening? We are having one more cell. Oh, sorry. We are having one more gene present over here. Let's say this gene is present over here. Okay. The name of this gene is BCL2. The name of this gene is BCL2. Pro-apoptotic or anti-apoptotic? Anti-apoptotic. Now, if due to some reason, hormones level decreases, or growth factor decreases, okay, or whatever cell injury happens, due to any kind of reason, if the cell injury has to happen, what will happen? Let's say we are talking about if the hormones are decreasing in that case. BCL2 is kind of a protector for the mitochondria or protector for the P53 gene. Look, P53 gene is very, very, very nasty kind of gene. How? P53 gene wants to gain access, okay, outside the cell. They want to leave the mitochondria, okay? As if in the childhood, we want to leave the school as early as we can, right? As the gates will be opening, we will be running out. P53 gene is something like that. BCL2 is some kind of guard for the school. So for this school, BCL2 is kind of a guard. If somehow some injury happens or growth factor is decreasing, hormones is decreasing, BCL2 will not be able to stop. BCL2 will not be able to stop this P53 gene to go out. Now BCL2 gene is getting affected, starts to get affected. They are starts to get destroying, you can say. Now what will happen? P53 gene will find its access outside the mitochondria, outside the cell. Now this P53 gene is present outside. P53 gene is present outside over here. What will be happening? This BCL2 is converting into the pro-apoptotic gene now. It is converting into pro-apoptotic gene now. And let's say we are having now back or backs. Back or backs. Now what will be happening? They will be leading to the activation of caspases. They will be leading to the activation of caspases. Okay. Mainly they will be leading to the activation of caspase number 9. We are having several kinds of caspases. Okay. We will talk about the extrinsic pathway also. There will be talk about caspase number 8. So here we are having activation of caspase 9. Now if the caspase 9 is getting activation, it is having the capacity to stimulate two kinds of enzymes. What are these two kinds of enzymes? One is the proteases and one is the endonucleases. One is the proteases and one is the endonucleases. Proteases, what it will be doing? It will be destroying your protein synthesis. It will be destroying your protein synthesis. And endonucleases, what they will be doing? Endonucleases, what they will be doing? You know, they will be splitting the nucleus. They will be splitting the nucleic acid of your nucleus. So what they will be doing? Destroying your nucleic acid. If you are having destruction of protein synthesis and if you are having destruction of nucleic acid, will your cell be able to survive? Your cell will not be able to survive. So what will happen? Cell death. So this is one of the way of destroying the cell by the help of intrinsic pathway. So what is happening? First of all, P53 gene will be coming out from the mitochondria. If it will be coming out from the mitochondria, this BCL2, which was anti-apoptotic, it will be converting into the pro-apoptotic gene, and pro-apoptotic gene will be stimulating the caspase-9. Now this caspase-9 will be stimulating what? Proteases and endonucleases. Proteases can inhibit the protein synthesis, and endonucleases can inhibit the nucleic acid formation, nucleic acid synthesis. So what may happen then? Finally, you will be having the cell death. This was which kind of pathway? This was the intrinsic pathway for apoptosis. Intrinsic pathway for apoptosis. Now, let's talk about the extrinsic pathway. So remember about the pro-apoptotic and anti-apoptotic gene. Now look over to the extrinsic pathway. Okay, intrinsic pathway means some kind of problem is happening inside your body only. For example, chromosomal abnormality can be there, or something, some kind of stimulus is coming from inside the body only. Okay, that is the intrinsic. Extrinsic means you are injecting something and after that apoptosis is happening. So that is the example for extrinsic kind of apoptosis. Okay, that will be the example of extrinsic kind of apoptosis, because you are injecting from outside, or you are giving something which is from outside, that will be considering around the extrinsic pathway. Okay, now in the extrinsic pathway, what will be happening? You know, let's say we are having the cell again. This is the cell. Okay, and onto the cell, we are having some kind of receptors. We are having some kind of receptors. So these are the receptors present over here. Okay, on the inner side of it, they are having the sites for binding. Okay, these are the calcium binding sites. These are the calcium binding sites. Now we are having two things which will be binding over here. Which two things can be binding? One thing can be Fas ligand, and one thing can be TNF alpha. So these two things can be bind to these sites of, or sites of these receptors. Okay, so Fas ligand and the TNF alpha. Once they will be binding to this thing, okay, Fas domain death receptor will be activated. First, the binding will be confirmed by the TNF-alpha and the Fas ligand. Fas death domain receptor will be activated. If the Fas death domain receptor will be activated, it will lead to stimulation of caspase. But this time it will be caspase number 8. So what it will be doing, actually it is converting your... Actually, this enzyme, this death domain receptor, is converting your pro-caspase 8 into caspase 8. And if the caspase 8 is activating, what it can do? Activation of two enzymes. What are these two enzymes? Proteases and endonucleases. And if these two enzymes will be activating, again what will be happening? They will not be able to do protein synthesis, and they will not be able to do nucleic acid synthesis. And what will be happening as a result? Cell death. Okay, so this was the intrinsic pathway of the apoptosis. This was the extrinsic pathway of the apoptosis. So in both the cases, there is the activation of caspase. In both the cases, there is the activation of proteases and endonucleases. Okay, and finally cell death is happening. This one? No, that is the death domain receptor. This is present over here only, but I wrote over here because there was no place to write. Fast death domain receptor will be activated whenever the binding will be confirmed. Okay, with these sites, whenever the binding will be confirmed, then this death domain receptor will be activated, and that will lead to the activation of this caspase 8. Okay, so these are the two mechanisms by which the apoptosis happens. One is the intrinsic, one is the extrinsic pathway. One more thing, in the gel electrophoresis, have you heard about gel electrophoresis? In the gel electrophoresis, we are having some kind of patterns by which you can analyze whether it is necrosis or whether it is apoptosis, as far as irreversible cell injury is concerned. Okay, so let's say that this is the slide over here. If you are finding this kind of pattern, we call this pattern as smear pattern. We call this pattern as smear pattern seen in necrosis. I am talking about what? Gel electrophoresis. In gel electrophoresis, if you are finding this kind of pattern, this pattern is called as smear pattern. Smear pattern is seen in necrosis. Okay, if you are finding this kind of pattern, okay, usually look, we are finding this kind of pattern in the normal cell, but because there is the use of endonucleases will be splitting the nucleic acid, so that's why you are having which kind of pattern? Okay, this kind of pattern. This kind of pattern is also called as step ladder appearance. Step ladder appearance. So smear pattern is seen in, or step ladder pattern you can say. So step ladder pattern or step